Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bife here. So, I think we need to talk about Osiris again, because now we know a little better what's happened to him. For those of you that didn't play the first story mission of the Season of the Lost just yet, we have big spoilers inbound. For those of you that don't mind, let me go ahead and recap you really quickly. Osiris apparently helped Lakshmi II to create the portal in the Botsa district, which helped the Vex invade the city. This was at the end of the Season of the Splicer. After this, he fled to the Dreaming City, where he was found by us and Saint 14 in the presence of Marasov, the Queen of the Reef. From here, the terrible truth was revealed.
I had hoped you'd find your way back.
I'm a bit lost, actually. But this feels familiar. Do I know you?
Osiris! You must come home! Answer for what you have done! The Vanguard will show mercy!
Yes. Ikora and Commander Zavala are nothing if not generous. Queen Mara, look how they've welcomed the Crow into their flock.
It isn't too late. You can still be forgiven.
Be careful. I'll hold you to it.
Lower your weapons. Osiris still lives.
You trust this thing?
This thing and I have come to an agreement. You need only cooperate.
What is it?
I am Savathun, the Witch Queen, Sister of Shapes, deepest in the Hive Coven, etc., etc. My sister Zivor Wrath hunts me on behalf of another. I wish only to be free, and Marasov has graciously agreed to help.
And Osiris?
Sweet that you should care, little bird. I have been Osiris for as long as you have known him. But rest assured, I will return him safely to you, in exchange for your assistance.
Queen of Lies! Pray this is the one time you are telling truth. The Vanguard must know what has happened here. Stay, Guardians. I will go.
Someone once told me that the line between light and dark is very thin. Walk it alongside me. For Osiris. This will guide you. A powerful relic of awoken design. Take it and return to your helm.
Savathun had been in the guise of Osiris since his lost ghost, Sagira, had been killed at the hands of Shivuo Wrath's High Celebrant. I think it needs to be clear that if Bungie was writing a villain here, they are doing so very well, because Savathun then immediately, at the end of the first seasonal story quest steps, starts to basically gaslight us. For those of you that don't know, gaslighting is when someone essentially feeds you a false narrative to make you question your own perception of the world. It's often used in the context of a bad relationship, but in this instance with Savathun's penchant for deception, it makes absolutely perfect sense that she'd be doing this here. In this cutscene that follows, she attempts to reframe all her actions as the actions of a friend who is merely trying to help us this whole time. Take a listen, but don't believe her.
Who is Savathun, you ask? You already know. Oh, guardian mine, I am your friend. I tried to protect you from the Black Fleet. You called it interference. Don't worry, I was not offended. Instead, I found a form more pleasing to your eyes. Osiris was lost, lightless. I saved him from Zivu-Arath and assumed his shape so I could guide your victory against her. I ferried the reborn prince to your city so he could be redeemed. I protected Zavala from Keitel's ambitions, ending a war before it could even begin. I delivered the House of Light on its knees to Ikora. I unmasked the enemies lurking inside your city's walls and destroyed them. You may disagree with my methods, but you can't argue with results. I am no villain, and you are no hero. We are paracausal.
To make it really, really clear, all of this, bunch of lies. The interference she and Nokris ran between us and the pyramid was probably done with the intent of delaying our interactions with the darkness and potentially preventing us from gaining its power. We still don't know why she saved Crow, although it seems more than likely now that he will be a tool that can be used to weaken the resolve of Queen Mara Sov. Her opposition to Zivu-Arath is a clear motive as to why she helped us to defeat the High Celebrant back in the Season of the Hunt. With Keitel and the Cabal fighting Zivu as well, and potentially playing a future role in some of her plans, Savathun was bound to find a solution that would not weaken a potential enemy of her enemies. The arrival of the House of Light was perhaps meant to be part of a plan to tear the city apart from within. And between our destruction of Coria and our dismantling of the Endless Night, I think that we actually foiled one of her plans. After all, at a certain point in the season, Osiris does state that he would not underestimate us again, and after we destroy Coria, he is notably irritated, saying that maybe we shouldn't break open every bottle of champagne in the city. Yeah, seems as though Savathun didn't quite anticipate that one. And of course, when it comes to Lakshmi 2, I think the point at which Lakshmi 2 was killed by the Vex was, yeah, definitely Savathun's doing, but I think it was simply meant so that she could discard an unneeded tool and perhaps use it as a way of suiting her narrative. Of course, that also sowed some political instability in the city now that the factions are gone, so yeah, that almost certainly suits her purpose too. The truth of the situation may be more complicated than I've just stated, but what seems clear is this. Savathun is not in any way our ally. You can blur the lines of good and evil, hero and villain, sure. But ultimately, you've got to remember that we are bargaining with a being that has made genocide her calling card and has seen to the destruction of entire civilizations, all of this unfolding over millions of years of violence. She cannot be trusted. It is a mistake to think anything close to the opposite. Your resolve has to be strong. Do not sit there and let her words convince you otherwise. But what about Osiris? If Savathun has been simply assuming Osiris's form the whole time, what's been happening to him? The honest answer, tragically, which we can now tell, is that Osiris has always been there, watching every moment of these last few months unfold, and has been trapped, unable to do anything about it. The new lore for the wolf-tone draw bow makes it very clear that Osiris has indeed been inside his body the whole time, and that he's been powerless to act with Savathun manipulating him, and effectively speaking through him. He's not even consciously been there. The lore tab of the bow reveals the extent of this tragedy, as momentarily Osiris is able to lucidly reach for the surface and is able to perceive just small bits and pieces of reality here and there before being dragged back down into the depths of subconsciousness. The lore tab reads as follows. The slithering dark is cold against my face. I cannot speak, cannot breathe. I reach for Sagira, but then I remember. I form a fist, but feel nothing. I am bound, and as I thrash, the images cut fissures through my mind. Someone, the Awoken Prince, he helps me to my feet, but I still struggle in the dark. And now she is standing, thanking him, but she uses my voice. My voice! She has stolen my form, my voice, but someone will see my failure and cast her out. They must! A glimmer of sunlight. How long has it been? Zavala looks at me, at her, considers her words, poison cloaked in wisdom. I cry out. He must know. Zavala, listen, listen. You know me. You know not to... the smell of night flowers. I am walking. She is walking through a moonlit garden. And there is Ikora, speaking, laughing, nodding. Look, Ikora, look at me, don't you see it? Pay attention, pay attention! I taught you better than this! A woman, an exo, sits before me and sways, eyes vacant. But inside, she is sinking as well. Now her voice, her true voice, humming, a gyre of sound. And the exo sways faster and faster. I hear his voice and push to the surface. Saint. No, 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 I scream, but there is no sound. He looks into her eyes. He smiles. He reaches for me, but it is not me. Saint, that is not me. Please, please. I am weeping, but I cannot weep. I am nothing. Only heat and hate. Only sickness and shame. Trust me, I hear my voice say. And I drown again. All of the moments in the last few months as Sagira's death has been excused as the reason for Osiris's unusual behavior, Savathun has been behind his every move. From taking the crown of sorrow to his arguments and conflicts with his lover, Saint, to his fascination with the Vex domain and our infiltration of it, for his requisition request where he asked to see the light-suppressing device of the Scions, even down to the point at which he was collecting Hive ghosts to store in his quarters later for some unknown purpose. None of these actions were of Osiris's meaning. He is responsible for none of these moments. Savathun has been the one making these points of time happen all along. I can't help but think back to this moment above all, which perhaps encapsulates the tragedy of the situation the best. This is the moment from the Boots of the Assembler lore tab, one of three small parts which all comment on Osiris at this moment in time. It's between Osiris and Saint, and it reads as follows. Saint 14 was doing munitions inventory when Osiris swept into the room. Saint put down his datapad next to a crate of grenades and stood up. Osiris scanned the shelves of guns and ammo, looking for something. Saint stood dumbly, waiting for some kind of acknowledgement. When it was clear that none was forthcoming, he called out. Osiris, what are you looking for? His voice was loud and strained. Osiris didn't turn from the shelves. The light suppressor that the Scions used on Zavala's ghost. I need it for my research. Zavala kept it, I think. Ask him about it, Saint replied, trying not to sound put out. Osiris faced his partner. His eyes narrowed in thought. Very well. Then, as an afterthought, thank you. As the former warlock turned to leave, Saint called out. I was hoping we could spend some time together soon. Just the two of us. Doing what? Osiris inquired with a small smile. We could fly out to the Alps, Saint suggested. Or walk around the ruins of Prague. Like we used to. That seems fine, Osiris said. He shrugged a shoulder. Provided the city doesn't burn to the ground in our absence. Then, after a beat. Is that all? Is that all? Behind his helmet, Saint frowned. I suppose. Osiris strode from the room, leaving Saint alone, with a sinking feeling in the pit of his stomach. Normally, at the end of videos like this, I try and sum things up and say something, but I don't know if anything more needs to be said than these two things. Don't trust the Witch Queen. Let's go save Osiris. And also, I suppose, when Saint gets his hands on the Witch Queen, oh my gosh, that is going to be a moment to behold. Anyway, if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and leave a like, and don't worry, I will be going over more moments of Saint 14 and Osiris, but more importantly, I'll be going over Osiris and the many moments at which he was very clearly now corrupted by Savathun, looking back over the last few seasons. So we'll go ahead and we'll take a look at all of that as kind of a prelude to everything. With all that being said, if you did enjoy the video, go ahead, leave a like, hit the subscribe button and the bell next to subscribe, to turn on those email notifications. And of course, if you have any thoughts of your own, leave them down below in the comments section. But in the meantime, know that your viewership, as always, is quite enough for me. And that my name has been, my name is Bife. Parodasia ad Astra. I'll see you, Starside.